Walter, thanks so much for joining today. I work for Neustar as a product marketing director. Neustar is a company that helps you know your customers, orchestrate their journey, and optimize your investments. Stephanie, can you please introduce yourself?
Sure, yeah. Thanks, Jeff. Stephanie Mays. I lead the sports partnership strategy for MGM Resorts, both domestically and internationally.
Terrific. All right. Thanks, Stephanie. Let's get right to it. Perfect. You've had quite an interesting career throughout the travel and hospitality industry. Can you please talk a little bit about your career path to your current role at MGM?
Sure, yes. Well, I started my career as a student at UNLV, and I was a part of the hospitality program. And through that, always had a lot of great opportunities to get connected to industry leaders on the strip and the events, just the breadth of what we had in the city. So through that, I found my way as an intern for the local PGA Tour event, which is now the Shriners Children's Open. And there I really found a passion for sports and working in with the PGA Tour and everything that came with it. So throughout my career, I kind of fought tooth and nail to try to find a position after college that would be in that same space. And they created a position for me to stay on full time. So I was able to spend about four tournaments with the tournament, which I loved and miss often, but wanted to look for career growth. So I tapped on MGM Resort's shoulder. They were actually a client of mine from the tournament. And I said, I'm looking for growth. I want to learn more in the industry. And so jumped on board with MGM Resorts. And through my time with them, have just had some incredible opportunities to work on the corporate beverage programs, working with some of the biggest beer, spirit, and non-alcoholic properties that we had within MGM Resorts. And through that and the development of entertainment and sports, just have found my way always looking for that next project and, you know, kind of raising my hand for the stretch projects that would get me to, you know, leading the sports department where I am today. So it's been an incredible opportunity. Doors have been opened through my leadership, and just excited to be here with the group today and able to share a little bit about what we do at MGM Resorts.
That's great. And I heard you mention the Running Rebels, UNLV there. Yes. It seems to me that you are one of the few people on planet Earth that actually is currently working in a job that pertains to your major from college. So how did you know from an early age that you really wanted to get into travel and hospitality?
Yeah. So I did always know I wanted to be in this space. I was fortunate enough to travel throughout my childhood. And through that, I just had a love for the feeling that I received as a guest and you know, kind of getting taking days off school and over summertime. And then I was also able to see the things that also didn't maybe go so right that maybe had an impact on our vacation. So I came to college thinking I really want to help people have a great experience. I wanted to be a part of this story. So that's where UNLV came into play. And then of course, through that, you never really know what careers you can have until you start diving in. And I did work at a hotel for a number of years at the front desk, learned a lot there. But again, opportunities open up to you once you're in this space. And so I love that today, you know, I might not be working in the hotel directly, but I get to be a part of everybody's experience when they're coming to an event, when they're watching sports at one of our venues, or interacting with our brand at one of the Jewel events that we participate in. So love the connectivity that I still get, although I'm not always the person kind of at the front desk. So
that's been great. And you mentioned the PGA Tour and Shriners. Before we dive into the NBA, can you just briefly talk about the work you did with Shriners and everyone's favorite negotiators, the guys from Pawn Stars?
Yeah, absolutely. So my role, for those who don't know, PGA Tour tournament staffs are quite small. You have a small group of people that manage and run the tournament all year. And then you really rely on a group of volunteers and people that, you know, board that comes in to support. So through the tournament, I wore a lot of hats. One of them was player relations, managing the the players as they're coming in, their transportation and hotels. But outside of the tournament, one of the elements I was responsible for was community engagement. How do we get the community involved? Shriners was, you know, is a nonprofit at the end of the day. So how are we driving more exposure, getting more people to our tournament that will in turn benefit the Shriners? And through a tournament connection, we knew the guys at the Pawn Stars, and they are, givers in the community. So we paired up with them, and for a month of September prior to the tournament, they donated $1 for every shirt they sold to the Shriners Hospitals. So it was great to build that local collaboration with them. It was right in the prime. They had, just kind of came out and as the superstars and a great new show. So they used their fandom to help support us, which really put Shriners, you know, on the map in a new way, which was really exciting for our tournament. So it was great to get to know them through that.
That's awesome. Good for you being able to build those bridges. All right, so let's get on to everyone's favorite topic here, the NBA. Look, from the regular season to the playoffs, the draft, free agency, and of course, Summer League currently happening as we speak, the NBA has really become a 12-month per year sport. Mm-hmm. How does MGM capitalize on that?
Yeah, you know, basketball has always really had a place here in Las Vegas. We, you know, like to call, you know, Las Vegas the home of basketball. Throughout our history, we've hosted a number of sporting events. We have many coming up this fall and winter time. So Las Vegas is a basketball town. What we've been able to do with the NBA over the last couple of years is really latch on to the different tent poles that they have throughout the year and how do we become a part of that story. So we look at what our strategy and corporate pillars are. And one of them is driving events to Las Vegas. So throughout our relationship, we're always looking for opportunity to partner with the NBA and say, hey, have we thought about doing this here? We've been a partner with NBA Summer League as a title for a number of years. We look forward to continuing that relationship. And throughout that, we've been able to bring the NBA G League Winter Showcase here that takes place in December that wouldn't have come naturally had we not paired up with the NBA and said, how can we bring more to Las Vegas? We have hosted the WNBA All-Star Game for back in 2019, and we just recently had it here. That was, through our relationship with the NBA, wanting to grow and expand on how we can be a part of the conversation and give fans the experience at MGM Resorts that they may not be getting in other cities. And so we continue to look at the calendar that they have and our priorities and the experiences we can offer not only to fans, but also to the athletes, and are looking at ways we can continue to bring things not only to Las Vegas, but our regional properties as well. So always in the mix, looking to see how we can build on the experience and become a part of that.
For sure. And so as you think about your place in the sort of travel and hospitality space as it relates to the NBA, how do you think about your competitors as well? So for example, Travelocity also just ran a big campaign around the NBA finals about their partnership with the NBA. How do you think about, competing with other brands in the space, and especially as it relates to sports and the NBA specifically?
Yeah. We often say here in Las Vegas that when events come, it kind of raises all tides. So we do work really closely with the LVCVA to help bring, events to Las Vegas. We know that as a big player in this space, we're going to get, some of that attention as well. And really, in the case of Travelocity, we have partnerships with those third-party booking engines to help us drive our business. So while they might be, promoting that business, there is opportunity for us to partner with them on the back end as well. And so one of the areas we're looking to expand is how do we pair with the other partners in the NBA and continue to use their products to drive some conversation, MGM Resorts as a host and an experience that we can bring together and then drive additional conversation. I think one of the interesting things in that space is because we are an integrated resort property, and then we do have the sports betting opportunity as well through BetMGM, we also have an opportunity to, in some cases, provide more than others. We are not just a hotel and resort. We have food and beverage. We have live entertainment. We have the gaming side of our business. So really, we have the opportunity to mold ourselves into what consumers are looking for. And that's taking each part of our business and identifying what the consumer wants and at which place in time they're going to want that and how do we position that in front of them. So we look at all aspects of the business, and we are looking to other partners to build those conversations with us.
It's interesting you mentioned the gaming piece, because logic might show that as, folks are gambling more frequently on the NBA, that ratings would go up. But the ratings have actually been down for the NBA on TV over recent years. What do you think is driving that? And what does that mean for NBA sponsors and partners?
Yeah. I think, there's so much more content available in a lot of different areas. So I don't necessarily think that the ratings really show the entire story, because now you have brands and you have the league themselves they're all diversifying where they're placing content, because now, especially after last year, consumers are looking at content in different spaces. So the ratings are one element, but you know, their partnership with Oculus, what did that drive and how was that measured against what is on, you know, the TV broadcast? That's something to consider. And then we have to say, how are we becoming a part of that? And are our fans looking at the social, the YouTubes, all these different areas? So really, when you look at it, it's about the whole ecosystem. And I think we've all developed over the last year to realize that, you know, where that content lives is really about what that consumer wants, and making sure there is a target that still wants the broadcast, but there's the target that wants, you know, I think I heard on the last program, the snackable bites, right, from the social and whatnot. So it's really tailoring the message and the content so that you can really address the needs of all your customers. And I think they've done a great job. And I think as brands, we have to take a look at what are we trying to accomplish and in which space do we fit against all of those.
For sure. And so to that point, you mentioned Oculus, there's TV, there's online, there's, you know, every time a highlight happens in the NBA, it's on social media within seconds. What impact does that have on your marketing strategy, tactics, and your marketing mix when there are so many different places you could theoretically put your message?
Yeah, our media mix, we really look at it, again, as a brand. You know, it's not something that somebody can go in, you know, from the resort side, you can't just go and pick up the beverage from the local, you know, grocery store or whatnot. So we really have to be thoughtful about where we are putting our messaging. And it's a tiered approach. So there's the general message of we are MGM Resorts and here's kind of our corporate campaign, but we like to drill into the markets where we have regional properties and we're driving that conversation. Hey, get together with your friends and come to one of our properties and experience the game from a viewing, you know, from one of our tap sports bars. It becomes a viewing experience. And that's what we're trying to accomplish, is how do we provide that experience to fans that might take them out of their home and into one of our properties. And that could be done in a number of ways. So we look at our mix and there's the overall brand campaign, but then it's drilling down into, again, those different demographics and what are they looking for. But then at the end of the day, when we get to these big pillars like NBA Summer League, it's all about driving those fans to our market. Come be a part of that experience. Come be a part of the crowd. Cheer with us, you know, at the arena, and then come and enjoy the evening back at our properties. Because then after the basketball's over, you still have the food and beverage, you still have the nightlife, and you still have the concert entertainment experience. And so it's really finding the right moment to promote that throughout the life cycle of an event. So it's ever evolving, and we're looking to develop more content that shows how fans might experience that. So I think that's kind of the next evolution of where we're going, is not just doing the brand messaging, but also showing the experience people are having, which I think will get more people excited.
And it sounds like you've got so many touch points with consumers, be it, you know, sending folks off to your regional locations, getting folks, you know, into Vegas, you know, and then, you know, experiencing all the rest that MGM has to offer. So there's a lot of legs seemingly that sort of branch off of that partnership. How do you measure the overall value of MGM's partnership with the NBA?
Sure. There, right now, we're really hyper-focused on a couple of our key pillars. So our BetMGM product is of course, the new brand that we're leading with. It continues to expand, you know, month after month of entry into new markets. So the BetMGM brand has a very specific goal and target. And so it's really looking at that and saying, how can we leverage the content that we're getting through the NBA to drive more of those customers to our product? And in turn, you know, then how can those customers work with MGM Resorts and get some of the benefits that we can offer. So it's about what that ecosystem looks like and how we're grabbing more fans to become a part of our story there. The other areas are just kind of what I spoke about, bringing people to Las Vegas, curating these specialized events like NBA Summer League, G League Winter Showcase, and how are we bringing the fans to our properties? That really tells a story, because we do know that when people are here, there's the history of what we think customers are going to do. So having the fans at our properties is really key for us, that we're looking to measure and continue to grow as we come up with new content ideas. And then lastly, I would say our loyalty. So, you know, we use hospitality that we have to drive our customers back to our properties and how we can leverage those throughout the season to bring our fans back to us, you know, and then host them. You know, we're measuring, you know, where those customers are coming from and who should we be reaching out to? Who are the people in our ecosystem that, you know, we could drive loyalty with, whether it's a gaming customer or a sponsor that we work with that we want to say thank you to, you know, in all regards. So it's looking at each of the pieces and in each spoke of the wheel will have the measurables against them so we can track and see what's working and what's not.
Interesting. And you mentioned the fans. I think there are a lot of different ways that fans are interacting with the NBA these days. I think when I was a kid, it was all about loving your team. But now you see much more frequently the superstar players are changing teams. And if someone likes LeBron James on the Cavs, now all of a sudden they love LeBron James on the Lakers. Yeah. So what does that mean for MGM as you think about forming relationships with potentially teams or players versus the NBA as a whole?
Yeah. So our team relationships and all of our relationships are really built out of, you know, kind of the three pillars I mentioned previously is, you know, number one, are they in a location where sports betting is legalized and we have a skin in the game there? So that will drive the conversation as far as our sports betting product. And if there is that opportunity to partner with them to drive that conversation, then when you look at some others, it's, you know, we've hosted preseason events in town before with the NBA. So how can we drive more of that? And we tend to work with partners that are going to bring those to us and are willing to work with us and take that opportunity to bring their team and another to Las Vegas to create that experience for their fans. So really, when we look at the teams, there's a number of different elements. And really, our goal is not in those cases, not always about the fandom of that team, but there's opportunity for us to capitalize on that because now, you know, as a partner of the Lakers and with LeBron there, what can we do with them to drive more of those fans? And they might be, you know, Lakers fans, or they may have been the Cavs fans, right? So how can we continue to drive them here? It's really about meeting the partners where they are and where they meet our objectives. And then we will find that story and we'll hear what our customers are looking for. And we'll mold it in a way that they do want to become a part of the story, even if, you know, they were a fan of one team or another.
And it sounds like you've got a lot to mold, right? I mean, the contracts, the partnerships, it seems like MGM is very busy. You mentioned in a recent interview that due to the pandemic, you actually had to renegotiate numerous partnerships and contracts. I believe you mentioned it was over 100. What was that like and what lessons have you learned from it?
Yeah, I think we were all kind of in a space of the unknown. And I think a lot of us had gone through that exercise with our partners and our internal teams. Specifically on our side, I mean, first, I feel like I could be a lawyer now. I feel like they should just give me my JD for that. But, you know, it was a time where we could really focus on what was important to us. And I think it did shift our priorities as a company and maybe not shift them completely, but really highlight what we are looking for. And when we went to our partners and shared our story, I think we came to it from a place of understanding because much like the sports industry, our industry was shut down. And so together we were kind of in it and had the understanding of where both partners were and where we both wanted to go. So what I learned from that is, you know, keep your eye on the prize and be able to flex and collaborate and identify the new opportunities and how you can go forward. And maybe it wasn't immediate in some cases, but others have flourished and identified new opportunities for us to grow for future years. So it's really about coming together and understanding your partner and then just making sure that you have your priorities so that everything becomes a win after that, right? I mean, every step we took after the closures became, hey, look what we're doing. This is great. And it was because we were hyper-focused and our partners met us where we needed to be. And we're really grateful for the support that they had. And now we're coming back. We've got the NBA Summer League. We hosted USAB training camp and the WNBA All-Star Game. So in working in tandem with them, really, we feel like we've come out bigger and we're ready to get back to sports here. And I think we've already done that in the last couple of weeks.
Good for you. Well, if I need some legal advice, I'll follow up with you offline for that piece. And in addition to the NBA, are there other sports that are interesting to MGM? I believe you might also have some partnerships in golf and rugby.
We do. You know, we run a full gamut of relationships in the sports space. So, you know, we have our league relationships with MLB, the MLS, NHL, as well as the NBA. We have team relationships across those sports. And then, you know, our ambassador relationships with golf was, you know, was born a couple years ago. And it's just a different segment of sport that we look to utilize. We've grown that golf ambassador program where we're hosting maybe one event a year and leveraging our relationships to have the golfers come out and join us. And now our golf program has expanded to include, you know, the CJ Cup, which we brought when they couldn't go international last year, the LPGA Bank of Hope, which we hosted this past May. So the golf program really provided a foundation for us to create new content and find ways to bring tournaments to Las Vegas where maybe we wouldn't have had them in the past. So that, you know, it's very event focused. And again, bringing fans, bringing the athletes to MGM Resorts was our focus, and we accomplished that. And then when you look at some of the rugby and the soccer matches we've had, you know, World Cup was here a couple of weeks ago, and we have leagues coming up. Rugby will be here at the end of October. And those relationships, you know, are driving business and sports to Las Vegas. We want to be in the conversation. We want to be where all sports are happening. And so we partner with those events that come into town. And why it might not be a full season long relationship with some of those, it provides us an opportunity to bring a new consumer to MGM Resorts and show them how we can host them and give them that great experience, which maybe they wouldn't have had before. So we're always looking at events. How can we support what's happening in Las Vegas and join the party?
So it sounds like you've given a lot of thought to how you think about, you know, treating sports fans and messaging to sports fans. Lots of people love sports, but not everyone. So how do you think about segmenting your customers and prospects to ensure you're serving the right messages and content to potential sports fans that might be joining you at MGM versus non-sports fans who are just there to, you know, enjoy everything else there is to do in Vegas?
Yeah, so, you know, we have a wonderful team and our brand strategy and our media team that is working really diligently with us to identify what is the sports segment. And we do that not only in the media that we have through our leagues and our teams, but to your point, on property as well. And we realize that maybe not everybody is in town right now for the NBA Summer League. We want to give them the opportunity to explore that, but we also have so many other offerings. So it is really a juggle between, you know, what's happening in town this week versus, you know, what a fan is looking for, or just a customer who's looking for the nightlife or the food and beverage or the pool and spa experience. So we work really closely with our team. And so, you know, MGM Resorts is a huge ecosystem. So it's almost, there's so many places that content can live that we just find that balance. And oftentimes we know where sports fans will skew on our properties. And so that's where we'll push messaging. We know that other consumers who might want more of a luxurious experience, we know where they're going to be. So we try to identify those locations ahead of time and make sure that, you know, each consumer is being able to see what they want, but also have the opportunity to maybe like a summer league.
Yep. So building an aspect of that. Looks like we're almost up on time. I'll give you the floor. Any other advice for our audience when it comes to sports marketing in general and specifically the NBA?
Yeah, I think what we learned is just to really look at what you are looking to accomplish, right? What is your strategy to connect with fans? What are you going to provide, and what conversation do you want to be a part of? And really taking a look at the different areas of the league, and maybe you don't have to be a part of everything, but find things that do resonate with you and do them well and do them big and continue to grow on those. And I think once you identify where you want to be in that space, you can find a really great pocket where fans will work with you and see the potential brand.
That's awesome. Jesse, I see you're back. Is that, time for the next one?
Yes, unfortunately, the time has ended, but Stephanie, Jeff, thanks so much. We'll both have you back on very soon. Really appreciate all the insights. You know, Vegas is such a unique story regarding the pandemic. So really appreciate the insights, and we'll have you both back soon.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having us, Jesse. Jeff, thanks so much.
Have a good one. Thanks, everyone. Fantastic. Well, up next, we have our last panel of these 3 days. It has flown by, but I think we have an incredible way to cap everything off.